फैकल्टी ऑफ डिफरेंट डिपार्टमेंट्स, स्पेशली हेड ऑफ द ईसी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केएल यूनिवर्सिटी, स्टूडेंट्स, फैकल्टी, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. एंड द प्लेजर्स आर आस्क मी टू टेलीफोन एंड आस्क मी टू गिव ए लेक्चर ऑन प्रैक्टिकल एंटेनास एंड व्हाट आर द लेटेस्ट ट्रेंड्स इन एंटेना टेक्नोलॉजी. देन आई सेम थिंग जस्ट आई went and told to my director DLRM, the SP Dash Garu. Immediately he agreed and he told immediately go and gather that lecture on EW antennas. Sir has already told about the DLRM. It is a premier laboratory in DRDO, which is engaged in design, development, production and induction of electronic warfare systems for tri-services. Army, Navy and Air Force, and we are delivering the EW systems for all the platforms, land based platforms, naval platforms, both ships as well as underwater vehicles, submarines, then airborne platforms, both aircraft as fighter aircraft as well as helicopters. So this laboratory is was established in 1962, and at that time technology was not that much matured, but the scientists who were joined during that time, they were very good, and they have established the base in development of the EW systems. So in the especially I want to say proudly that in DLRL, the antenna group is the only group which has developed total antennas indigenously without importing a single antenna so far. That because of SAR and another group friend was there, Dr. Rampal, then our ex-director Dr. Srivastava, K.K. Srivastava, he was the person who was heading the antenna group, and he steered each and everybody to work with our own hands to develop that broadband EW systems. Today, sir, today and my focus is because if you open the menu book, basics on antennas anywhere you will get, and basic theory of any type of antenna you take, you will get that theory. But how to realize what are the intricacies involved, that you never get unless you work with your own hands or you interact with the people who have worked in that field. So that is why I have given more emphasis on practical design and simulation, development, production of such antennas. What are the technically involved, just I am going to tell that. So I have organized my talk in these lines. Just I will do the basics on antennas, what are the application of the antennas. Then I will focus mainly on EW antennas and what are their objectives for these antennas for EW applications. Then once you are given the requirement, what are the steps we should follow in developing or designing this antenna? Just I have made one small flowchart out. We have to go about the antenna design. Then once you design, what are the simulation softwares available as of today? About 5 years back, such facilities were not available. We have to design the antenna, make the practical antenna, go for measurements, then depend upon the results. Again, you go for next iteration like that. At least 5 to 6 iterations we used to do to make one antenna to meet that particular requirement. Today it is not like that. If you make properly design the antenna and go for simulation and optimize, first iteration we can get the results. Then especially in EW, 3 applications are there. One is intercept and monitoring. Once you know the signal information, then you have to find out the direction. Then once you know the direction and pulse information, or the enemy radar information, then depend upon the situation you have to go for jamming. So what type of different types of antennas we are going to use for interception, direction finding and jamming, I am going to discuss. Another important area is people will never think about the radome, but that is past and partners of the antenna. You can make a very good design of the antenna, you can make a good antenna, but if it is radome is bad, everything is gone. Without radome, you cannot put your antenna on the platform. That is why radome also small portion I want to touch. Then what are the trends is going on in the antenna technology? Then once you make the antenna design, develop, realize, then what are the measurements you will carry out on antenna? What are the basic facilities required? Briefly and touch, then I will conclude. So this is the frequency electromagnetic spectrum chart. You see it is covering every, sorry. You see, this is frequency, just I have shown here from 100 kHz to 10^21 Hz. That means total frequency spectrum of electromagnetic radiation we have covered. So each spectrum is having its own advantage, one's application. That means in this, the wavelength is varying from kilometers to fraction of an atom. So mainly the radio spectrum what we are using is this is the spectrum we are using for different applications. Say this is 100 kHz to say 550 kHz to 600 kHz we are using for broadcast. Then FM 88 to 198 MHz we are using for FM radio and TV broadcasting. Then this micro spectrum L band say 1 GHz to 30 GHz micro spectrum. This is widely extended for defense applications. And now we are using millimeter wave also, 32, which starts from 32 300 gigahertz, but mostly in EW applications we are using up to 40 gigahertz. Whereas 94 where low window, low atmospheric windows we are using for missile applications, because in missile applications size weight is very very important. So as you go ahead at frequency, the component size as well as the antenna size will come down, giving the same performance. So that's why 94 GHz and 36 GHz people have expanded for use in radar and missile application. But till now, such application is not existing for EW because of certain practical limitations. So you can see here, this is for radio we are using, this is for FM radio, TV broadcasting. Now cell phones we are using 2.4 GHz and then radar 1-200 GHz in different frequency band we are using. In the same band, wherever radar band is existing, EW is there. It is a cat and mouse game. When radar is coming with good performance, we have to counter that radar. So we are working on EW. So today my topic is antennas. Now first, before going to the further, these are the definition, you know, everybody, it is taken from all textbooks only. As per IEEE standards, antenna is a device, for radiating or receiving the radio waves. That means it is a device which converts the guided wave into free space wave, or we can call it as a impedance transformer, because the free space impedance is 377 ohms, whereas we are working with all 50 or 75 ohms. So it is basically making a this impedance transformation from 70 or 50 or 75 ohms to 377 ohms. So how we can classify these antennas? There are many ways, but this is one way of classifying the antennas. We can classify the antennas based on frequency. If you classify the frequency, we are going very low frequency, low frequency, high frequency, VHF, UHF, microwave and millimeter wave antennas. If you go for aperture, you can classify the antenna based on aperture, like wire antennas, parabolic dish, microstrip, patch antennas. Then you can classify the antennas on polarization, like linear polarization, circular polarization, linear polarization, there is vertical and horizontal polarization. This vertical and horizontal polarization mostly we use for communication and radar. Whereas in EW, we never use vertical or horizontal. We use circular polarization or a slant linear part way. Because in EW, we do know the direction, frequency and polarization. So depending on the radiation pattern also, you can define the antennas, like isotropic. This is a reference antenna, we never get an isotropic antenna. mostly we use directional, omnidirectional antenna. That means in one place it is a omnidirectional, in other place it is a directional. This type of antennas we widely use in EW. Then directional antennas, then hemispherical antennas. The directional antennas widely we use for direction finding and jamming applications. So if you classify the antennas on frequency, very low frequency antennas are vertical radiant, star loaded monopoles, T and inverted antennas. Because here wavelength is very frequency very low, wavelength is very large. So the star loading monopoles normally we use to reduce the physical dimensions of the antenna. At the same time, vertically it maintains the required height to meet the requirement. Then medium frequency antennas like monopoles and dipoles and directional antennas it is used. High frequency antennas like logarithmic antennas, conical monopole and inverted cone antennas, vertical whip antennas, what we see mostly in our vehicles, rhombic antennas, fan dipole antennas. Very high frequency VHF and UHF antennas like Yagi-Uda antennas, logarithmic antennas. This Yagi-Uda we all know we are using it for our TV reception. Helical antennas, panel antennas, corner to flutter antennas, parabolized, so like this. Super high frequency. This comes under microwave EHF antennas, mainly parabolic dish, which is having a very good property. With simple construction, we can get the narrow beam and wide frequency coverage. Then pyramidal horn antennas. This pyramidal horn antennas we are using widely in EW as well as in other radar applications. Disc cone antennas, monopoles and dipoles, and microstrip patch antennas, fractal antennas. This is a new concept to know antennas. Mainly the fractals are multi-band antennas instead of broadband antennas. Suppose you want to get the frequency operation at 2-3 different frequencies. From a single aperture you can get this operation. So these are the, some of the common applications. This patch mostly people are using consumer electronics, mobile handsets, and they are using in phased array and GPSN. Then horn antennas. The main application of horn antennas is to feed for the reflector. They are used as a gauge standards for antenna measurement, EMI, MEC test, communication systems, radars, direct finding, and millimeter systems. This waveguides, phased arrays, radar, high power systems, reflector fields, circular polarized systems we are using. The plane of spirals, this is what Sir has already told. This is a widely used in wideband systems, multifunction apertures, electronic warfare, ultra wideband systems, reflector fields, telemetry, direction finding, and missile guidance. The conical spirals. This is also falls under the category of frequency independent antennas and used in EW systems and used wideband systems, circular polarized systems, aerospace systems also it is used. This Vivaldi antenna. As far as printed circuit antennas concerned, so many papers, so many books are coming on printed circuit antennas. This is the only antenna, Vivaldi antenna, which is widely find the application EW. No other antenna I have not come across any of the other antennas than Vivaldi. This is widely because of its wide bandwidth characteristics. This is used in multifunction apertures also and electron warfare ultra wide band systems. Logarithmic antennas. This is also having very large bandwidth. Again, we are using in EW systems direct finding. System direct finding antennas as a rating element. This is again in consumer electronics it is used. Bowtie antenna. This is also one printed circuit antenna which is having broad band characteristics, widely used in phased arrays, radar, wideband systems, RFID, then ground penetrating radar, this GPR. The biconical antenna. This is widely used in EW systems. Because okay, electronic warfare, EMC testing, and ultra wideband applications. So these are the various parameters of the antenna. So whenever you go for a market, you want to buy an antenna, what are the parameters you should ask? The way we go for a market to buy a shirt, what the type of this cloth it is, made from which company, and what is the type of yarn it is used. Like that you will go through even a small item, you go and ask what are some parameters. Like that, suppose you want to purchase an antenna. So what are the characteristics or parameters we should look into? So first and foremost is the frequency and its bandwidth. Then once you define the frequency bandwidth, what is the gain of the antenna? You know how you can define the gain. It is with respect to isotropic antenna, what is the power it is constructing in the desired direction. Then VSWR, this gives the matching characteristics of the antenna. Then beam width, so this decides the your coverage area, how much spatial coverage you want. That decides, thus is decided by the beam width. Then polarization, so whether it, you need a vertical polarization, horizontal polarization, circular polarization. In circular polarization again, you know, is the right circular or left circular, so many things are there. Then this is the action ratio, this is defined only for circular polarization. This will tell about the ellipticity of the circular polarization characteristics. The action ratio become 1 when it is a purely circular, but most of the antennas give apical polarization where action ratio is more than 1. Then side lobe level. So with respect to the main beam, first side lobe, what is the level it is down with respect to that? If you go for radar applications, always we need very low side lobes. Why? Because the radar systems are more prone for jamming through side lobes, not the main lobe. Because the main lobe beam width is only out of 0.1, 0.2, 0.3 degrees. So the availability of the beam in that particular direction is only that beam width of divided by that 360, because it is covered 360 degrees. So probability of jamming a radar through main lobe is very minimal. So always jammers are designed for power levels through side lobe jamming. So that is why the side lobes are very very important for radar application. Another important requirement for radar is this side lobe should not be same off axis, because as you move away from the bore axis, if side lobes are very high, there is a chance for bore jamming. So that is why we have to go for monotonical decreasing of the side lobe. As you move away and away from the bore side, the side lobe should go on decreasing, so that the front to back ratio should be 50-60-70 dB down with respect to main beam. Then this is a power handling capability. This is also one of the important. Suppose you want to design an antenna for jammer, then the power handling capability is very important. If it is a receiving application, there is no issue. But if it is a transmitter,